The Prime Minister's back on the international stage, flying to a United Nations summit in New York. On the sidelines, world leaders will discuss how to combat the ongoing anti-US tension that's gripped the globe.
For more, we're joined by political reporter Leah Craven in Canberra. Leah, will this distract the Australian government from what it wants to achieve at the summit?
No, the Australian government sees this as an opportunity to meet other world leaders and to lobby them to vote for Australia in its bid to get a seat on the UN Security Council. So that will still happen. But as we've seen, Australia hasn't been immune to these protests. We've seen that there is a section of the Australian community that's angry and disaffected. Obviously, on an international scale, it's a much bigger problem. Some of these protests have been very violent and there's an anti-Western sentiment coming from the protesters. So it's in Australia's interest to be part of the solution here and to encourage other governments to talk to their population and to encourage peaceful demonstration rather than hatred.
With a spring in her step, the Prime Minister's bound for New York. Julia Gillard will address the United Nations General Assembly and lobby for an Australian seat on the UN Security Council. Her foreign minister's already there pursuing the bid.
We've been very encouraged by support we've had.
But dominating the international summit is how to ease growing tensions in the Muslim community, following international protests over a film mocking its prophet, Muhammad. Bob Carr's meeting Arab leaders, presenting a four-point plan that urges against protests.
They will always be taken over by an extremist minority.
And promotes peaceful engagement.
To advance the tenets of moderate Islam using publicity and invoking the power of persuasion.
What is missing from it is an unequivocal statement condemning the violent behaviour.
Back home, Muslim leaders have been praised for helping to prevent a repeat of last week's violent protests. Community leaders are saying they're doing all they can to help calm the anger from some disaffected Muslims.
And bring a more diverse set of voices to the table at community meetings.
Women were included, young people were included, and they were listened to. That's historic, and that's, I think, the future.
A future, she hopes, marked by peace.
Now, Silma Iram was a guest on Meet the Press this morning, and she's pushing for some changes within the Muslim community in Australia. As we heard, she wants more representation by women and young people so they can have their voices heard. But what she's also calling for are for imams to deliver some of their services in mosques in English so that some second-generation Muslim Australians who may not speak English can also understand this and not have any of the message lost in translation.
OK, Leah Craven in Canberra, thank you.